trading world can get complicated, especially when there's so much jargon involved that can leave you scratching your head. If you want to be a part of the conversation about trading and thoroughly understand what everyone is saying, these terms can help you. First, we have the bull and the bear. When the market is regarded as bullish, it's on an upward trend that indicates a strong market. When it's bearish, it's going down or it's a weak market. Next, we have day trading. What this means is when a trader buys an asset or sells it all on the same day. Swing trading is a little different. Swing traders will hold on to their trade for a long period of time, overnight, or even a few days in hope that the market will swing in their favor. Penny stocks are stocks available for below $5 a share. You can purchase as many shares as you want for that low price of each one. You may have heard the term volatility before, and it refers to the effect certain events have on the stability of an asset. For example, interest rates can make the currency experience some periods of high volatility dependent on decisions made. Companies can often go public by selling a designated amount of shares into an open market for anyone to purchase. This is called an IPO or initial public offering. This is often done to raise funds and increase the company's value. Lastly, we have support and resistance. Support levels indicate a downward trend that cannot go past a certain price point because demand is strong. Resistance means that selling has been strong, so an increase in price is less likely. Both of these will help traders to identify where the trend is heading and whether it will stay that way or reverse. Using these terms in your next conversation about trading will help you sound like a pro in